You're listening to the SWN podcast.
And this is SWN.
Welcome to SWN.
Skull! Skull! Skull!
This is SWN.
And this is the Scottish Wrestling Network.
Where Scottish wrestling lives, I guess. Is that a tagline? I guess. I don't know.
Hello and welcome to the SWN podcast. I'm your host as always, Billy. It's going to be a very choppy episode because we're doing it in bits and pieces because we're going down to Edinburgh. Say hello, Kelly.
Hello, Kelly.
We're going down to Edinburgh to see Discovery Wrestling.
Excuse me.
That's not the reason why we went down to Edinburgh. So the backstory is we booked to go see Hamilton.
Yes, we did.
That was last year. And then round about February time, I started pestering then owner Discovery Wrestling, Alan Good. Are you guys running round about then, Friday or Sunday? And I was given a little bit of the tip off that it was Sunday that we're running. And then once the tickets went up, we're going to see Discovery. So, Hamilton and Discovery, you get to see a musical you've always wanted to see. I get to see Discovery Wrestling for the first time since they're in set. Well, I've never seen them live. And they've been running for 10 years.
Yep.
We're both winning.
I think I'm winning more than you are.
That little cough in the background is Jack. I think it's his first. Oh no, I was going to say it was his first cameo.
First appearance.
There was the episode where I was doing the bit. I was Dundee for Fair City, and I was doing the little bit afterwards, and he cried because I was feeling it while I was doing it.
Oh wow. That is.
There was that.
That's the risk you take.
Yes. So this is Saturday. We're travelling down on Saturday, Hamilton tonight, and then it's Discovery on Sunday afternoon. We've got recommendations for food. We are excited. We're hyped. We'll do a little bit more of an actual preview when we're in Edinburgh. I'm all over the place. I'm too excited. I'm hyped. So yeah, it's just going to be a quick intro on our way to Bucky to drop off the boy to Granny and Granddad's and the dog.
Sandy's featured as well.
Sandy is somewhere. Sandy is probably just shaking in the boot. She does not like the car. But that's it. So yeah. Quick intro, I'll see you later. Might be a montage, might not be. I don't know what's going to happen.
Be warned, we're drinking on the train.
We're going to be drinking on the train. I don't plan to record on the train, and then that's going to cut to the next bit where we're just like pissed and giggling on the train. So yeah, it's good. I'm excited. Let's do this. Let's go. The time is now about 8:30 in the morning. We're on Sunday. It is Discovery Wrestling Day as I try to make eye contact with the camera. We're in Edinburgh. We are ready. We went to see Hamilton last night. My voice is dead because of that. which was incredible. An incredible show. So, you know, Discovery, you've got a lot to live up to. Kelly's just getting ready. So I thought I'd just jump in on this weird hodgepodge of a podcast. We're going to try and do a little bit. Maybe not after the show, but like the travel back up, we'll maybe do something in the car between Bucky and we'll pick up Jack and pick up and go home. That's possibly the plan, or maybe we'll do something later in the week and I will just edit all together and we can speak about the show. But so far there's 5 matches announced. Kelly doesn't know a lot of the names on it, to be honest. So I was trying to give her a little bit of a ready reckoner on who's who on this particular show. So I did an All About the Disco preview, so I've kind of explained most of the matches on that. But I'm excited for all of them, really, because there's all got guys that I've wanted to see or know and enjoy seeing. So like the open week title match, Judas Grey defending against Ravy Davey. I've really enjoyed Judas. I think he's fantastic, even if he does still keep launching stuff at me. So will that happen today? We'll soon find out. And Ravy Davey is always entertaining as well. So it's a nice little combination of risk taking, high flying, you know, kind of high risk style. Not necessarily high flying because Ravy Davey, but there's always kind of a risky element to his wrestling that we're going to see. I said really just mellow because it's really early in the morning and I haven't had breakfast yet, and like I said, my throat's dead, which is going to be a running theme I think for the next few weeks, because I've got like I've got like 5-6 recordings or things to do in the next week, 2 weeks or so. So it's going to be a test of things for my throat, which has always been testy at the best of times. So yeah, that's going to be a lot of fun. The tag title match, very excited for Skull Brawl versus Kings of the North. Whether we're going to get Visual Recipe, Kings of the North, Bones on Damien Corvin, or if we're going to get Adam Maxted in there somehow. I'm hoping for a tag title win. That would be lovely. That would be a nice way to round off our Edinburgh trip. Seeing an amazing show in Hamilton, then seeing Skull Brawl win the tag team titles in Discovery, that would be lovely. We've also got the Triple Threat Women's Match, Emerson Jane, Casey and Myla Grace. Never seen Myla Grace wrestle live, so good to see that. I haven't seen Emerson Jane wrestle in September, because I went to Fair State Wrestling when she wrestled Ian Ambrose in the main event. So, but it's been a minute anyway since I've seen Emerson Jane wrestle. Gene Money, I'm so excited to see Gene Money. I'm excited to see what Kelly thinks of Gene Money as well, because he is quite a unique fella when it comes to his presentation in wrestling. I guess Ryan Richards, who is a Highland boy, even though he doesn't present himself as that, he's from up our way. So it's cool to see him in the big title match, the wide division title match on the show. I guess it's the other match, the tag match. Joe Hendry, of course. Got Joe Hendry taking on Leon Slater, which a wide division number one contendership match, which is like the big match, like the big high pressure match to deliver. Because this is both two TNA guys. Joe Hendry has got the single coming out Monday as of recording. It'll be out and hopefully charted by the time this episode goes out into the ether. And against Leon Slater, who again I haven't seen wrestle live before, but I've seen clips and I've seen enough to know that we're going to be in for something special, you know, because he's a very flippy dude, and Joe Hendry likes picking up and throwing guys. So it's going to be a nice little combination of stuff that we're going to see. Hopefully I'll get to meet some folk I always see at Discovery shows. That it's always very fan friendly. There's always loads of pictures of the wrestlers, and hopefully I get to do the same. I took like a bunch of these with me. I don't know why, to be honest. I had like loads of them because Sticker Mule had a big deal on them, and I got like 50 of them for £9. So hopefully, so if you want some, I will have some with me, my little bum bag here. But yeah, so that was just a quick little bit. I might do an extra bit with Kelly Kabzu, and let's hopefully montage it up soon, and then we'll do a little bit at the end. So it's probably gonna be quite a short episode, just because we've tried to fit a lot in, not just wrestling wise, but just our holiday wise here in Edinburgh. So I'm gonna leave it for now. I'll be back in a second. I might put the SpongeBob SquarePants in a few moments later thing, and then I'll repeat the card again. So see you shortly.
2 hours later.
Hi.
Oh, this is very nice. We should do this more often for podcasts.
We don't have these chairs at home though.
I know, but you know, tripod there.
I'm just gonna film myself in there.
We look comfy.
Tripod there, tripod here.
Yeah. So I've grabbed you because for the first part you were driving.
Yeah.
Second part you're in the shower.
Mm-hmm.
I definitely told everyone to shower. It wasn't any Tuesdays. And you're right for the third part.
I didn't hear my electric toothbrush and thought it was something else.
No, or your Hamilton tribute.
I was not doing a Hamilton tribute.
Not in that moment in time.
So,
Discovery. It's our first Discovery.
Mm-hmm. We're discovering Discovery.
I'm excited. We've figured out where the bus stop is, so
stressing.
I'm not stressing about that. So I've kind of ran through the card from the last bit, but I'm going to talk to you.
That was yesterday.
Oh, so that was the bit where you were shouting and I ran through the card as well.
Oh, okay.
So I've done it this will be the third time.
Okay.
So I was saying in that bit that there's a lot of people that you've you know, but there's a lot of people you don't.
Yes.
At the same time. So, whilst, is there any names that I, when I was giving you your wee ready reckoner of stuff, any ones that jumped out on you that you're like, okay, well, I want to see what this guy's about?
Joe Hendry.
You've never seen Joe Hendry.
No, I've never seen Joe Hendry. So I'm quite excited that I'm going to get to see him.
Mm-hmm.
I've seen Ravy Davey once before.
Yep.
At a rock and wrestle show in Inverness. So I'd quite like to see how different he is, because that was about 5-6 years
ago.
That was
a lot. That's when we got engaged.
That was before we were married. So
yeah.
That was a while ago. And I'll be honest, I don't really remember who else is on the card, but
of new faces,
yeah. I know that Andy Wilde's on there. What's his new name?
Andy Roberts.
Andy Roberts.
On the poster, so I'm assuming he'll be.
So it would be nice to see him again. I've not seen him for a long time, but the last time we saw him was at a WrestleZone show.
As well, yeah.
I'm looking forward to seeing both you and my favourites, because I know them.
Skull Brawl, yes.
Caleb and Aspen. And I'm looking forward to seeing what Judas Grey decides to throw at you today.
Yeah, that's fun. Apparently there's going to be a big announcement Joe Henry's going to make. So we had a wee 5-minute speculation in around Hamilton yesterday, so
okay.
Who knows what it's going to be. Is it going to be an affiliation with TNA? Is he just going to go up doing Eurovision next year? Who knows?
Maybe he's doing the Olympics.
Maybe he's doing the Olympics.
Because he did the Commonwealth, didn't he?
He did, yeah. So that's going to be an interesting one. So
mm-hmm.
I'm really excited for this, because yeah, like I said, Hamilton, we were buzzing yesterday.
I'm looking forward to it, but my excitement
you kicked your side off yesterday.
So yeah, as much as I'm looking forward to seeing the Discovery show, I'm quite happy that I've got mine.
Yeah.
This is your turn.
So
you know.
We'll make this a Hamilton review podcast, even though we probably could.
Oh, it was just so good.
So it was a bit incredible.
It was just amazing.
Absolutely incredible. So
that was wild.
And now we've got here as well. So yeah, we've got.
There's a few sightings. I think there's something happening around about us today.
We know Andy's not in Edinburgh yet, because we haven't spelled the Tiger Bomb. So once we do, we'll know Andy Roberts is in town.
Yes.
You're disappointed that there's no foundation announced.
Yeah, I was a little bit disappointed because you said that they could be on the show, because they sometimes. They sometimes show up at Discovery shows, but then that's the way the cookie crumbles.
Yeah.
You can't control these things. So
exactly, we're not the bookers.
We're not the bookers, we are not.
Get into Discovery's DMs and go, if WrestleZone's not doing
calm yourself, we're not a WrestleZone fan, a particular WrestleZone fan. So, I'm looking forward to seeing the show and how this one runs, because I've only ever really seen WrestleZone. I've seen like 2 or 3 rock and wrestle shows when they came up to Inverness and Forest and 1W3L. So it would be nice to see another company's arrangements and stuff. But
yeah.
The main thing I'm looking forward to is just being at the show.
Yeah, just getting there. And then we're going to try to go to Cerevino's, because
much recommended
by
wrestling fans.
Rob Stowe and Ian Skinner, especially, they have determined
so,
that
we love pizza. So
pizza,
oh,
yeah, and the barbecue tonight. It's gonna be good.
Barbecues, yeah. So
I don't think there's much more we can add. I mean, I'm excited to see what you think of Gene Money. I've said that a few times this weekend.
He's the guy that you said was really eccentric.
He's a bit eccentric. He's a bit.
Do you feel like you've oversold him?
Maybe he's different to what you get in a lot of shows I've seen anyway.
Okay.
And I'm really excited to see what you think of Leon Slater as well. That's who's facing Joe Hendry.
Okay.
So he's recently signed with TNA. He got signed during the UK tour they did last year.
Well, that's cool.
And he's, from the clips I've seen, he does this amazing Swanton 450 splash thing. And if he does it, I think it might blow your mind.
Okay.
You know?
I do like the whole acrobatics,
yeah.
Jumping about and flippy-floppy
yeah.
things. I really think.
And Joe's a good base for throwing people as well, so.
Well, yeah, like, he looks like he's got a good core and.
Mm-hmm.
He's strong.
Yeah.
I mean, a lot of wrestlers look strong, but he looks solid.
Aye.
You know. Like, plus he's the local hero. Is he still the local hero?
I think he's now just I believe in Joe Henry. There you go. See, taught you. So we'll begin to do that. Get the wave our hands side to side.
You know I like the joining in parts. Yes. So I'm ready for it.
Right. So we're gonna go and try to get the bus to Portobello and get our bearings.
Peace out. But
peace out. Let's go. Next bit. Montage maybe. Bye. Discovery. We are knackered. We are absolutely knackered.
Yeah, we are.
It is now, well, they don't know. It's midnight.
The tales of an immunocompromised parent.
And a fat man. Discovery Wrestling was bloody incredible.
It was just great.
We've got the bus.
Fantastic.
We did the paddock, we got the bus.
We found our way.
Stops outside Portobello
Town Hall. Thanks to everyone who recommended Cidovino's.
Yes.
The pizza was divine.
I had the jalapeno and chimichurri.
Regretted it instantly.
Definitely regretted it instantly because I spent the rest.
I just went for plain old margarita, but it was delicious.
I spent the whole show burping jalapenos.
I know.
In your face.
I know. Even the airwaves didn't stop it.
Yeah.
It's like the strongest minty chewing gum you can find.
Yeah, it wasn't. It wasn't the fun.
And even it didn't do the job.
So if anyone did meet me at the show, or wrestlers that are listening to this, or watching this, I apologise. We won't do a rundown of match by match, mainly because
we can't really remember
this moment in time. But we do know we enjoyed ourselves.
And we did.
So, but we got there, the doors opened late, so strike one. And then we got in, got sat, and we were just amazing. Started with Joe Hendry. Well, started with Leon Slater coming
versus
out.
Versus Joe Hendry.
And I told
I've never seen Joe Hendry before. He was fantastic.
Yeah.
And you told me that Leon was one to watch.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that boy is going places.
Yes.
I swear to God, he is not going to be on indie shows for long.
No.
He is so talented. It just oozes from him. He's, mm-hmm. Yeah.
As a crowd, his first time he's ever worked in Discovery Wrestling, and the crowd were chanting the area code. The 0121.
Is that what it is?
Apparently so, yes. I checked. That's his area code. So
what's 0121 the area code for?
You
don't remember.
But yeah, so they had the crowd chanting against Joe Hendry, who's the big
star, Scottish leader of the pack.
Yeah.
You know, and it was a Discovery show. Yeah, it was just. Even he said at the end of their match, though, that he's the future of.
Mm-hmm.
The business, and he is one to watch. If you get a chance to go and see him in a match, just do it.
Go see him, and we got him twice.
Go and see him you can, because like I say, he is not going to be on indie shows for very long. He's going to be snapped up by
he's signed by TNA, but they're going to want to have him.
He's going to be snapped up by an American company.
TNA are going to have him over permanently. He's going to be in the UK for long. So it was announced that then he'd be in the main event. He asked for his title shot that night, so we got two lots of Leon Slater.
Yep.
Do you want to talk about that one, and then we'll
yes.
So we've got Gene Money versus Leon Slater versus Ryan Richards. Gene Money
is the guy that's kind of almost dressed like he's a dog.
Yes.
Bit weird. Not gonna lie. Very good at what he did. I enjoyed the match. I didn't think it was entirely fair that maybe that Leon won against him when he's obviously been defending that title for a while.
Mm-hmm. He's had a very good wee while.
But, you know, the cards fell the way they fell.
Aye.
And,
You're a bit cold on Ryan Richards.
I'm not convinced with Ryan Richards. I think maybe a second watch of him might change my opinion.
Mm-hmm. You don't like heels.
I don't like heels.
Yeah, you're very much if you're a cheater, I make it like it.
I don't like it when people break the rules. I know it's wrestling, I know it's part of the experience, it's all pantomime aspect of it. Personally, I can't get behind someone that breaks the rules to win.
Yeah, so maybe if you saw him, I don't think he'd be... I probably could do a face run, but
he's got such a
heel face.
You know, there are good heels, and there are heels like he is, or there are heels that are still a good sportsman.
Right.
That don't cheat.
So just an example, like the Foundation are quite good at being bad guys, but they don't necessarily break rules at the same
but
time.
They do break
yeah,
rules.
Yeah, I know, that's probably not the best example.
That's a really bad example.
That's a really bad example. I was thinking more in the tag team sense, that they usually kind of stick with the tag rules.
But they still sneak a little cheaty-cheaty in there now and then, and I think they cut this isn't about them.
No.
I didn't gel with him on this show. That's not to say that he's not good at what he does. I wasn't a huge fan of
them. Yeah, well, that's your prerogative. There's people that I'm not a fan of it as well. So.
Exactly.
All good. So yeah, Leon Slater won. We got to see the Swadton 450 twice in a night, which it was a delight.
Beautiful.
And that corner, as soon as I saw him going up for that corner jump, I just turned to you and went, watch this.
Yeah. It was amazing.
I love the Gene Money bit when Leon and Ryan fought out the fire escape, but Gene just sat on the apron of it.
How was your day?
Yeah, that was good
crowd.
That's what I like about Gene. Well, for what I've seen of Gene on Disco, he's just like a very personable. He's like he's like your people's champion kind of thing. He's like man of the people, even if he
reminded
kind
of me a little bit of Scotty Swift.
Oh, all right. Yeah, kind of that. Yeah, that man, people in this kind of thing. Yeah, I can see where you go with that.
Everyone's friend.
Aye.
Yeah.
So elsewhere on the show, we got the big strong man, Adam Maxted.
Yes.
Which, this was your first, I think this is my first big strong man experience as well.
Yeah.
And I was pleasantly shocked by the big strong man.
Yes. He's got kind of Greedo vibes.
But like bad guy Greedo vibes.
Yeah. See, he's a heel.
Aye.
Right? But he played by the rules.
You don't. I get it now. You don't like a snidey, sneaky heel.
I like a funny heel.
You like a heel that gets a comeuppance.
Yes.
Of heel. Yes.
I like it when karma hits them in the face.
And we got
with
Adam,
a chair.
We got Adam Maxted, who I'll be perfectly honest. Before I've seen Adam Maxted in the past, he's been this kind of like he's just jacked and he's felt too jacked to me.
Yeah.
And he felt almost like plasticky kind of jacked.
Like look over substance.
Yeah, but seeing him wrestle, oh my god.
Yeah, he's really good.
This guy's good.
He's good.
He's got the springboard stuff.
I'm not a Love Island person. Never watched any of it since it became no unknown people. Like when Love Island very, very first came out, I don't know if you remember this, but when Love Island very, very first came out, it was all like names.
Mm-hmm.
It was like celebrities, like Darden Day and Miley Class and all that stuff, right? So I've not watched it since it came back, and it was like the Big Brother kind of aspect of it. So apparently he'd been in the villa.
Right.
I don't know if he won, I don't know how long he was there for, but you know, that's obviously where that's obviously what he's used as his jumping board.
Right.
To climb the ladder, so to speak, and yeah, you would almost think that he could rest on that,
yeah,
and not learn very much about how to do the job.
Mm-hmm. But oh man,
but he's good.
Big strong man. He held up his end on the bargain as well. He was such a smarmy, such a hilariously over the top. Bad guy.
Yeah, he was
grinding. And I mean, when you came out, you were like, "What the f is this?" And then by the end of it, you were just laughing.
He was the comedic factor. He was a crowd pleaser for that. Yeah, he was just top. He was top notch.
He was great.
Yeah, it was a good match.
I think we've got other things to speak about, but let's talk about the second match on the card. Which was for the vacant Discovery Wrestling Tag Team Championships.
Yes.
That was announced. We didn't get Kings of the North on the show.
No.
At all. Which you were at half us about because you've never seen them.
I didn't know who they were. So
we've got the Good Times, Rob Stowe and Monstro taking on a Skull Brawl in a no DQ match, which it just entailed a couple chairs. But
It kind of confused me a little bit because I've never seen a non DQ match. So I was a little bit confused that the bell didn't ring.
Yeah, I don't remember.
Because you said that the bell didn't ring because it was a non-DQ match.
No, I didn't hear Kwaku announcing it was a non-DQ match. I don't know how, because Kwaku's got such a carrying voice.
Where was all the one falls? Kwaku, come on.
We've got the table
a bit. I like the joining in part. Not the being involved. Joining in, but the pantomime joining in.
Exactly. Like,
I missed my one fault.
Like, but you got to do, say my name and he appears, I believe, with Joe Hendry. You got to do that as well.
I did.
Yeah,
I did. That was good.
A lot of fun. But the tag team match, it was just a big schmozzy brawl thing with, yeah, with chairs and that. And
yeah, well, can I say it was Caleb? It was a brilliant match.
I didn't hear and Caleb's ad libs, but I could hear it. I could hear him kind of like going, oh, we'll do this.
Spisham.
Kind of thing. I love that.
The guy in the mask, I don't remember names. But when Aspen and Caleb both had a chair and Caleb was like, squish him! And they just, it was really
good
funny.
Fun.
Yeah, it was good, clean fun.
And they won the title.
They won the title and we get to be on the same team tonight.
Yeah, because we're not going to be in 2 weeks, are we, Annika?
No, we're not.
We're not.
Even though I'm not going to make it. And I forgot to say tonight to Caleb, but good luck in Aberdeen Anarchy.
Mm-hmm.
Although I'm not there in body, I will be there in spirit. And don't believe whatever Billy tells you. I have not switched teams. You are going to win. Okay?
There you go. It's a prediction in a nice and early.
Even though it's not a WrestleZone podcast.
I know, but that just happens in my show.
But
my podcast, WrestleZone gets a mention, whether it's me doing it or my guest, because they know how to suck up to the podcast host.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, that was good fun. Speak to Aspen afterwards, and to Vol, he questioned why he still continues to do matches like that, because he hates them, as in they hurt him.
Yeah,
and I watched it.
I
don't know why, because
I can understand.
Because I've seen that chair spot where they put the chairs out on the other side, and then Rob Stowe ended up slamming Aspen on it.
Well, because you said that the rule is you set it up.
You go through it.
I've never noticed that before.
Now
you've said it. Yeah.
Yeah, general rule of thumb, if you see a table
the question has to be asked then. If you don't like those matches, why did you set the chairs up that way?
Go in.
Stupid.
Go in.
Stop it. Stupid.
Well, I came out with the Discovery Wrestle Tag Team Championship, so.
Show me why girls live longer than boys.
I know. I was going to say that. But the next match we're going to speak about isn't a good example of that, because Emerson Jane likes her death matches. The triple threat, Myla Grace had a bit of a warm up.
Yeah.
She came in a little
bit jittery.
I think
she was maybe a little bit nervous. I don't know if it was her first triple threat. I've never seen her before. I've seen Emerson Jane, and I've seen
Casey. But a different Casey.
Not for a very long time.
Yeah.
For either of them. But I have to say, from when I last saw Emerson Jane, under a different name, much improved for me.
Oh, was that 5 years, I think? Maybe?
Yeah, so but 5 years of a five years of experience.
We've been married.
We've been married 6 years.
Six years
in October,
since
but five and a half. Mm-hmm. We're splitting hairs here.
Aye.
But I'm not, I don't know what the professional things are to do and stuff, but I think she has improved.
Mm-hmm. I think we've kind of noticed
so much
with Myla, and she like a couple minutes in, a bit jittery, and then she kind of missed a springboard, and after that she was like, fuck, I was gonna hit people now.
Yeah.
And that's kind of how it went. And that's
like when you have your drive test,
mm-hmm,
and you're really nervous, and then you make a silly mistake. Not one that's going to fail you,
mm-hmm,
but one that you think,
yeah,
has failed you.
So
you go, oh well,
relaxed.
I fucked it now.
Yeah.
And then you pass. You know, it was like that. It was like it took away the nerves.
Aye.
She hit the fuck it button.
Aye. And
then she looked like she really enjoyed the match after that.
Yeah, she needed.
She just needed to hit the fuck it button.
And I think it's because she was in with Casey and Emerson, who's probably had that.
They're both hit that button
a long time ago.
Yeah, they both. I think they've both been in the business a wee bit longer, mm, than.
I would say so. Yeah.
What was her name? Macy.
Myla.
I think they've probably been in the business a little bit longer than her, and she looks young.
Mm-hmm.
Not that Emerson or Casey don't, but you know, she just looks new, and
mm-hmm,
I loved her ring attire. I thought it was so clean.
You really liked Casey's.
I really liked Casey's. She's right, like her ring attire is right up my street.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't know, now you do. Like, Nightmare Before Christmas. I saw her standing off at the side during the what happened at the end, which we'll get to. And she was wearing the Nightmare Before Christmas top, and she's a girl after my own heart. I mean, it's just our son's named Jack.
Yeah, but I've seen Casey's been one of those for me that I've seen kind of when she was part of the Owens twins with her sister Leah, and it didn't quite click for me. But I think that kind of thing that
loved
was proper.
It, loved it.
Proper. Like, I really enjoyed that.
I would love to see her at Hijinks. Halloween hijinks.
Yeah, just getting
she wouldn't need a costume.
Proper Halloween vibe up.
Yeah, yeah, she's got a proper Halloween, but I would love to see her. She wouldn't need a costume, but I would love to see what she did for a costume.
Yeah.
Because I think it would be. I don't think it would be family friendly. That's possibly why she's not been asked. But yeah, she was just.
Yeah, she was really good. But no, that was a fun match. Like I said, Miley just needed a little bit of needed that kind of fuck it moment just to, and then afterwards just went. I missed the finish of it. I turned around and then turned back.
I felt so bad. I asked you a question. You turned around. Emerson got the pin.
And that was it.
We missed it.
But so I don't know what move finished the match or anything like that.
It was a pin, but I don't know what kind of pin.
Yeah, exactly. But yeah, match itself.
Check me using lingo dingo.
So, really fun. Other matches what we're thinking of. We had a surprise Ronnie King appearance.
Yeah, it was quite nice to see another familiar face from the WrestleZone family.
Against Dave Conrad.
Because, like I said in the last part, I think, I've only ever seen WrestleZone, really.
Yeah, WrestleZone, Couple Rock and Wrestle, and the W3L. I think that's what we kind of summed it up on. So we've got Surprise Ronnie King. He took on Dave Conrad, making his return. His WrestleZone
Dave Conrad is like a cowboy book boyfriend. I swear.
Carried to the Gambler, and that's in my brain forever. So thank you for that, Dave.
Is it ever far from your brain?
No.
Because it's never far from mine.
I know, but it pushed out, I believe, in Joe Henry very quickly with the Gambler. It was a fun match. It wasn't Dave Conrad's another one that hasn't ever really clicked with me.
Yeah.
But
I don't think it was one to write home about.
Mm-hmm. But there's nothing bad. But
there was nothing inherently bad about it. Yeah. It was a really good match. It just it didn't stand out amongst the other ones that were on tonight.
Yeah. We love Ronan. We really love Ronan. So that's
He's another one that's going to go places.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
And it's good that he's with Joe Hendry, because if they're signed by TNA, he'll maybe get spotted.
Yes. Yeah. Hopefully.
Yeah, I would like to see him go far.
So I think we covered every match but one, I think, and that would be the Scottish Openweight Championship match, which was Ravy Davey against Judas Gray, who came out in a nice light silky shirt, and I turned to you and went, I'll take that, that's fine, I'm happy with that one. And then he looked for me.
He had other plans.
He went under the apron and threw a fleece at me.
A great big, it was practically an hoodie.
Pretty much, yeah.
What's he going to take to? Is he in anarchy? What's he going to take to that? A fucking brick?
Oh God, he's in a six-man match. I'm going to die.
You are going to come home with a black eye.
I'm fairly certain that's why the screw is loose in my glasses. So
maybe you owe him a new pair of glasses.
He's not going to.
Just don't aim for the face.
I know.
What you should do is when you see him throwing something, stand up.
Give him a wider target.
His match, again, there was so much happened in that show. I don't really remember the ins and outs of the match, but I like Judas.
As soon as I told you he was a Jeff Hardy fan, you immediately understood Judas Gray.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Screaming it.
He's
hit a light again. I love his ring attire. I love that he wears a skirt.
Is that kind of is androgynous the right word? Like kind of just he's just Judas.
Yeah.
There's no kind of he's this or
it's almost it's
Judas,
almost right? Like a non-binary character. They're fantastic.
He's just Judas.
Judas is just, he's good.
Ravy Davies throwing in some moves there with the springboards and all that kind of stuff.
Again, another one who I've only seen once before in a really long time ago.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, when I saw him, like, I noticed today he was actually wearing his own tracksuit. It had RDs all over it.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas when I first saw him, it was like a Burberry.
Mm-hmm.
He was Burberry from top to bottom. He was just and he came out with a JD Sports bag.
Yes, so he did.
So that's a long time ago.
Right.
You're probably talking, the 6-7 years mark. So it's a long time since I've seen him, and
he was good fun.
Brilliant. It's a shame he doesn't come any closer than Peterhead, because that's quite a journey from us as well.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, another good match.
Yeah, I think it's like there was no inherently bad matches on the show. There was plenty
and
to enjoy.
Like I said to you, I'm not normally a fan of women's wrestling. It's not nothing against it. It's just a preference I have.
Mm-hmm.
I really enjoyed the women's match tonight.
Yeah, I think when you watched Scottish women's wrestling, which again this was like years ago. We're talking pre-marriage kind of thing. It felt like all the hits were a lot lighter, and since then it's now feels more like
they get into
wrestling
matches.
It feels like they're not afraid to hurt each other.
It felt like before, it felt like it was just ticking a box.
Mm.
You know, oh, we've got to have a women's match.
Mm.
We'll get these girls. They're all pretty good. I mean, saying that, we've seen Dewdrop before.
She's now Piper Niven.
Oh, she's Piper Niven, okay. Make your mind up. But, you know, we've seen Viper, we've seen, you know, Kaylee Ray.
Yeah.
And so we've seen some of the best female wrestlers. Mm. It's just never really gelled with me. And like you say, before, it just felt like it was a bit lip service-y. Like, we're having this female match, but...
It's on the show, don't worry.
It's on the show. They're in a nice outfit. You know, mm-hmm. Let's tick the box. They're in there, they're out, they're done. Whereas this was a proper, like, it could have been men in there.
Yeah.
You know? And it would have still been as good.
Yeah, I mean, it could have, even if
you
it
know,
was...
You know, whereas before, if the female match was men, you'd be like, is that it?
Aye.
I'm probably not articulating myself very well.
It felt lighter, but now it actually feels like that they're having a match kind of thing. And that's the last few years. I mean, the ones that we've signed by WWE, like your Viper, your Nikki Cross, your Big Storm. I'm just confusing all of them. Alba Fire, Kaylee Ray. They were the ones that were doing the laying it in a bit harder, all that kind of stuff, and then they moved up. And then it seems to be that it's been realized, we need to actually
do this.
And ever since done that, Casey's done that, and we're getting to see that. And Myla was doing that.
In the words of Kenny Rogers, you're going to learn, play the Game Boy, you've got to learn, play it right.
Yeah. Damn you, Dave Conrad. you're sexy cowboy hat and everything.
Well, country's very in right now.
It is.
I'm certain I've got a couple of cowboy book boyfriends on Kindle. I might just read that on the train.
Well, I played Pokemon Crystal. That's the modern life. So I think that's all the matches. I can't think of any more offhand. So the ended angle was...
When they were drawing the...
Oh, yes. I've put it in the results, but I didn't technically put it as a match. Yes,
I don't know if it was counted as a match because it wasn't billed. But
yeah, we got Chip from the Disco Fry,
mm-hmm.
Who was confronted by James Zardos.
From the tax office.
Yeah, but James Zardos, right? When he has wrestling matches, he's like he's as you can tell, he's a bit of a Tory kind of smug
right.
But what he does is he gives the crowd. Quizzes like anagrams, and it always inevitably there's one at the bottom that spells a rude word, and you've got to and it's there's one I can't remember how it was, but it looked like it was spelling out penis, but it's spelling out something different.
Uh-huh.
So I just thought it was just a funny little bit in there. It's like you saw smug at that, but it's these things he puts out of the room.
Oh, right, okay. So basically, he's like
really kind of the bar teacher, you know. You come back to me when
you've got a better school bond.
When you've got a tan that matches your neck, kind of.
Your face matches your neck.
That kind of ish vibe. So yeah, he came out all in tatters because clearly in the last show, Chip had jumped him.
And he lost his job.
It was weird.
Yeah,
I don't know if I liked it, but it was weird.
Yeah, I wasn't sure about that match. Per Quacko nearly got in the way.
I did enjoy. I really enjoyed James Erdos. I don't know why. I think it's just because he was just like, ugh.
But yes, yeah, after Leon got his belt though.
Yes. Joe Hendry came out for his big announcement, and before he could make his big announcement, he was jumped by Rob Stowe and Modstrom.
They came back out.
No, Mr. Manival, disappointed. We'll see Mr. Manival, but you know, we'll move on. Like Mr. Manival, I shouldn't. He attacked. Adam Axed came back out.
Yeah.
Blah blah blah. Ryan Richards got involved. To help the bad guys, and then just as it was kind of settling down, Judas Grey ran past and gave Joe Hendry a low blow, and as the dust was settling, the group was on the stage, and Joe made the announcement that Leon Slater will have a defence at the next show, which is the 14th of July, I think was the date on the poster. He'll have a defence.
Definitely not doable.
Ryan Richards will be doing something as well. But the big announcement was, from that, it'll be a six-man tag match. Judas Grey, Rob Stowe, Monstrum against Adam Maxted, Joe Hendry, and...
Elias!
The man formerly known as... If you'd actually heard of him as well.
Yeah, he's the guy with the guitar. I know who he is.
So he's now called by Elijah.
And the crowd went wild. Yeah, everybody sounded really excited.
So the show is called...
And the tickets are on sale now.
They will be, yes. So the show is called... the show's going to be called Walk with Discovery, because it was Walk with Elias was his catchphrase.
Right, okay.
So it's Walk with Discovery. It was a big announcement. It's a good get and everything like that. I kind of had in my head that, right, they're going to maybe announce that they're... Their shows are going to be on Disney Plus, TNA Plus, you know, because Joe's really, it isn't TNA. So I was kind of like, oh, that's a cool announcement, you know.
Not what you were expecting.
I was expecting something like.
Not that you're bigger. Disappointed.
Yeah.
You just drummed it up in your head.
It up as something that was going to be like big for the company.
Yeah, I can understand that. Yeah.
I mean, for all we know, between now and July, Elijah will sign with TNA, and that'll be. Supposed to go by now.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, Elias go by Elijah. So I mean that again, that could be quite a big dual branded TNA disco thing. So who knows? We'll see the future. But I think you enjoyed it.
I did.
I enjoyed it. It's taken me 10 years to go to a Discovery Wrestling show.
Yeah, I really enjoyed it.
I've finally done it. I got a picture with Skull Brawl with the tag belts. So I think I'm now. You got a picture with Skull Brawl with the tag team belts. So I think I'm now completing.
As Caleb said, I did Edinburgh.
Yeah, I'm trying to think if I've not got a picture with Aspen with any title. I think I've got him with all his titles that he's won now.
I think for the last 2 years or so, I have gotten a picture with Caleb. At every show I've been at.
You got with the tri-count east,
I'm not a stalker. I'm really not a stalker.
That's what stalkers say. So you got him with the tri-count east.
Alright, it's not baby reindeer.
You've got him with the Regal Rumble trophy, and now you've got him with the Discovery Wrestling tag title. So you've the only one you're missing is the Fair City title.
And the belt from Anarchy, which I'm not going to be at, but he's still going to win it, so...
I know, I think he's going to win as well.
It'll be fine. So
I think this is due to come out the Friday before the show as well. I have stuff in the works to go out in between. Hopefully, fingers touch wood, not been done yet.
Hayley Wood's best.
So I'm not gonna announce it on this. Although it'll be done by the time it goes
acrobatics.
Just be careful.
Yeah, don't jinx it. But no,
it's very exciting stuff.
I'm so glad. I can't believe it took me 10 years to go, but I'm glad I finally got to go.
So we've been together 10 years. That's how long it's been that you've been wanting to go.
Yeah. And it's been, it was well worth it.
It's
so.
Been like, same like the time I was wanting to go to Hamilton, but you know.
So I ticked off Hamilton from your wish list, and from mine a little bit, mine's not, but not as hardcore as yours.
Just
Scubby Wrestling off
this
mine.
This isn't a Hamilton podcast, but if it was, we'd be here all night.
So from us, in our hotel room, which I've realised I've positioned the camera in a really weird way, where we're only like in the bottom third.
I think it's trying to hide the beer bellies from too much food.
I know, we've eaten and drank so much
the
last 2 days. So we're going to go
join. If you're ever in Edinburgh, go to Bubba Q's,
that was good.
It was amazing.
So good. So we're going to enjoy the rest of what's left of our alcoholic beverages, so we don't have to take them on the train home tomorrow. And I don't know what's next. I'll probably be back in the studio, back in my office. And I will maybe do a little bit more of thoughts and feelings about matches as I remember them. But we wanted to really just do this as soon as we could, because it gets all the first initial thoughts out of the way. And then a couple of days later, I'll probably think of more logical things to think of. But in the meantime, this has been us. This will be Kelly's last appearance for a wee while.
Yeah.
I don't know where the next one you'll be on. It will be Nations.
It will be Nations.
It will be Hijinks, because we're going to leave this that night.
Oh no.
So it might be a Viruri. That's possibly going to be the next one. That'll be September.
That might be Jack's first one.
Possibly. We don't know yet. Fingers crossed. But if it is, oh my god, that's going to be a meant. That's going to be a crazy podcast, because he'll be speaking at that point. Like, properly speaking at that point. So
we hope so anyway.
He can give his thoughts and opinions on things.
Are you okay?
Do you like that match?
Snoring.
Yeah. Do you like that match? No. We'll get it.
Did you like Caleb? Yeah. That's
Do you like Caleb? No. Well, where are we? Huntley. Yeah, it's gonna be.
I wouldn't do that to my child. Don't believe him.
It's gonna be awkward 40 minutes. Anyway, right, we're gonna go. Bye.
Peace out.
Next bit, studio. Enjoy.
And we're back in the studio. Welcome back to the podcast. I'm on my own now. Back on my own. What a night. Afternoon. I keep saying night. I keep saying Y Division Championship as well, when I mean tag team or any other championship. That was incredible. You know, I'm going to do a write-up by the time this goes out. I should have a write-up on the site. We've got the All About the Disco recap. It'll be already on the places as well. But overall, they've got a great operation there at Discovery Wrestling, and I had an absolute blast. Like, even the weirdness that was Chip and James Erdos, that was a bit weird, but I really enjoyed it. I enjoyed Chip. I really enjoyed James Erdos. And he just had a little cadence to his talking, his character, that was just, I really liked. Because it was about him trying to figure out if Discovery Wrestling cooking the books, and he found nothing. He found nothing about that they were doing anything untowards. He was really disappointed by it, and It got right. Just the way that the tone shifted a little bit was just was great. The wrestling itself was absolutely top notch. Absolute entertainment. Leon Slater, my god, this guy, what, 19 years old? Disgusting. That's why I needed to go get a signed rookie card here for Leon Slater. Unfortunately, I got smudged on transit on the way home. But you know, I got a rookie card here of Leon Slater. For good reason, because that guy is money written all over him. Joe Hendry was a delight in watching him operate. He's very professional wrestler. He puts that professional in there, so you can see him during like the interval, during after the show a little bit. I had to run to go get a bus, so I didn't get to hang about as much as I possibly would have liked after the show. But you can see he's very in tune and business minded on how things operate and how things work, and it was just great to see. It's great speaking to Scott, who's on camera duties. I get to speak to Kyle, who was just trying to get into the balcony, which he did eventually. There you go, spoiled it for you, Kyle. We've got to see a lot of people that I've been aware of. I've met a couple of times, but like get to see people that maybe I've only seen on the internet. and now I get to see the real life, and that was really cool. I got a handshake with Gene Money. I didn't get a picture because I'm an idiot, clearly. But I got to shake Gene Money's hand. We've had him a guest on the podcast before, and I'm glad that I was able to meet him face to face. So as far as wrestlers goes, he was the first wrestler I got to interact with at Discovery Wrestling. So he officially popped my cherry. But it was a great night. Judas Gray, as much as he likes throwing things at me, my God, that boy can wrestle. And that boy can wrestle good. He had this great, like, he had this moonsault, a standing moonsault he did, and he like floated for a moment. Like floated. I don't understand how that is possible. But he floated. And it was just amazing. Great seeing Ravy Davey. I told him that I'll be seeing him in July. I'll be going to Pierhead for that show at the football club. And it was just a really good day. A really good show. The big strong man. I don't know how, but he was incredible. That guy, he has worked on every little facet of his being to be like still unlikable but hilarious. And I don't understand the concept of that. Adam Axted, I think I said in the previous part that he's never been a guy that I've never really been drawn to. I think it's always because he's looked so like well polished, too polished, you know, as like most of the promo shots and that. But when seeing him in real life, he's just a really rugged. I was going for handsome and rugged. I went for rugged. A really handsome, rugged gentleman as well. And he's a great wrestler. He shouldn't be doing those high flying things that he does with the springboard drop kicks and all that kind of stuff. But I'm glad that I got to see Adam Axted wrestle. I think I was speaking to Kelly about it, and we're trying to figure out where we'd seen Adam Axted before. We're trying to think. It was either ITV World of Sport or Five Star Wrestling. We couldn't quite remember where she'd seen Adam Axted before because we don't watch Love Island, so no idea from that. But yeah, it was really great. I was glad to see Adam Axted. So I mentioned Judas Gray, the women's match. It's like I said, Miley Grace had a little bit of a stumble. She seemed a little bit stumbly in the opening going, and then she's, again, said it in the previous bit, but she seemed to slip on the bottom rope when she was doing a springboard. It was just like, fuck it. I'm just gonna smash people now. And that was great. And from that point onwards, she was phenomenal. She was just really good. But yeah, that little hesitation in the first couple of minutes, I was like, oh no, poor. For any wrestler, I see you do that going, you've let maybe the moment get to you, especially if you're in the ring with two people that are very well-known, especially in Discovery Wrestling, but wrestling as experienced wrestlers like Emerson Jane and Casey, maybe the moment's got to you. But yeah, once she had that little slip and just went, I'm just going to smash people now. Phenomenal. Great. Great seeing Skull Brawl win the tag titles. Rob Stowe, who got his one to watch little trophy, if he wants to show off that trophy, he is more than welcome to. All expense was spared when I was making them. Right, I'll tell you from there. Right, they were supposed to. I've got these little shite trophies, and what was supposed to happen? If I can find, hang on. Right, so what was supposed to happen is I'm supposed to take one of these, right, and take one of these round stickers. Unfortunately, stickers are too big for the trophy. What I have to do is going to cut out the sticker and put it on the trophy. However, it's like all bobbled. So it looks okay from like here, but when you see it in real life, it's bobbled. It doesn't look, I don't like it. So I just went with the Sharpie. I just put a Sharpie in it. All expense, like I said, as I said, all expense was spared during the making of those. But yeah, Rob still got his. There was a bunch put back, mostly because it was Disco Guys who was getting it. Although Andy Roberts' one for Pro Wrestling Ready is there. So whether he receives it, I don't know. It's direct with my hands. So I think that's just about everyone. Casino Brutale's the only one that haven't got theirs. And Eric Young, I think it's the only people that haven't got their trophies from this year's one. I've still got a bunch from last year. Iron Girders didn't get theirs last year. Moxie Malone, I think, didn't get hers last year either. So there's a bunch outstanding from previous years, which will eventually iron out in the wash somewhere. Overall, though, I'm not going to leave this too long, because I've still got a montage to make as well for this episode, as it's loading in the, stuff's loading in the background there. It was a fantastic night. I'm glad that I was able to finally take Discovery Wrestling off my old wish list of shows. As a weekend in general, it was amazing. We got to see Hamilton, and Hamilton was just an absolute blast as well. If you do have the chance to go see Hamilton or Discovery Wrestling, go do it. By this point, by the time this episode goes out, we'll find out if Joe Henry is in the UK charts or in music charts in general. He's currently, as of recording, 1st of May, floating somewhere in the UK charts. I think he's number one on iTunes just now, which is mad. Unfortunately, that song wasn't the one that stayed in my head after the show. I do love it, and it's still there, still whirling about. Unfortunately, it was Dave Conrad's The Gambler. Although Dave Conrad was to release The Gambler, you do it. You do it, man. You go for it. David Cave, you go do it. The Gambler stuck in my head so much. I've seen all this music stuff. Ian Skinner is again his theme tune release, which is ace as well. Go check that out. I think it's called Hot Dog. Go check Ian Skinner's social media. Just do that in general. Just go for it. I've had a really good time. I've got a load of recordings over the next couple of days, a couple of weeks, to kind of just leave my June as kind of free as possible, so that I can arrange the Day of Birth Bonanza, and then maybe we'll take Day of Birth Bonanza, maybe 2 weeks off from the podcast, normal podcast, and then we'll be back with the Peterhead episode of our road trip. We do a road trip to community pro wrestling Peterhead. That sounds like a plan. Might do that. But in the meantime, thank you for continued support SWN, the Scottish Wrestling Network in general. We've been very busy, and I'm just enjoying what we're doing. I'm tired, but I'm enjoying it, you know, which is fine. It's been a good wild ride so far, so we'll look for it to continue. But in the meantime, this has been another SWN podcast. Go manscaped.com/.com, use SWN20 for 20% off. Go to renderbomb.com. I use SWN10 for your first order. Get 10% off with free shipping. And just have a good time, people. Go check our social medias. Go have fun. Go watch some wrestling. Enjoy it. Trust me. Do it. Anyway, right. On to the next one. Got more recordings to do. So until next time, go watch wrestling. You know, you dig.